Всем привет, друзья! Сегодня мы находимся в Мельбурне в отельной школе. Это маленький кампус, который располагается в самом центре Мельбурна.
Is that true?
Well, the industry in Australia, the industry average for students and graduates from the hospitality and tourism sector is just over 10%. What that means is that only 10% managed to find work within a certain period of time. With us, with a hotel school, 92%.
92%. 92%
of our students. Absolutely. 92% of our students are working within months of graduating. And 6 out of 10 of them are working before they even finish their course. And that's an example. The reason is because of a hotels that we own. For example, you have this over there, Hayman Island, which is one of the most popular hotel destination in Australia. That's owned by us.
Yeah.
And students who want to do their internship on the beach, they can.
Yeah.
And what I was saying was that our connections, part of the hotels that we own and the connections that we have as well.
Yeah.
We are very well connected with other of the best hotels in Melbourne as well. So all of these actually allow our students to find work. We help them, plus the skills workshops that we offer to prepare them even more to be able to find employment. So
ребята,
it all contributes.
Работа на большую вероятность гарантирована. А мы продолжаем наш тур дальше.
Students, in addition to the workshops that I'm going to get to, these are just examples of the hotels that we own. So these are some of the best 5-star hotels in the country. The Intercontinental in Sanctuary Cove, the Intercontinental in Sydney, which interestingly.
So in other words, that the hotel school is owned by Malfa and owned by Southern Cross University.
Correct.
And Malfa owns all those hotels that
Absolutely.
We can see on the photos now.
Mm-hmm. Including the Hayman Islands. So we have students who are there by the way doing their internship on the beach.
Ребята, эти отели владеются отельной школой. То есть это не просто отельная школа вас чему-то учит. Отельная школа владеет всеми этими отелями. Не только этими, но еще большим числом отелей. То есть они владеются, и вы можете там проходить свою практику и работать там. All right.
So here we have an example of the extra support we offer to our students in addition to the classes. So there's always something going on here every week. These are just a small example of the extra skills we teach you, everything from interview skills to resume writing. We have responsible service of alcohol for anyone who wants to work while they're studying. If you want to work in a bar and such, we teach that as well.
And so, and it's that's everything for free.
Absolutely, except for the responsible serving alcohol, but everything else is absolutely.
Ребята, смотрите, курсы, которые есть в дополнении к основному курсу, которые идут абсолютно бесплатно. То есть вы можете знать, как написать ваше резюме с профессионалами. И любые другие курсы, которые предлагает отельная школа, все идет бесплатно, чтобы вы смогли построить вот такую карьеру в отельной индустрии. А вот здесь вы можете увидеть студентов отельной школы, которые добиваются огромных успехов в индустрии. Так. И еще один студент. То есть это реально, это работает, и это служит в дополнении к основному курсу, как я уже сказал. То есть вы можете стать настоящими профессионалами. И смысл отельной школы, что вы не просто получаете образование, вы получаете навыки, теорию и практику, которые позволят вам стать профессионалами своего дела.
Yeah. Because we want to have a smaller unit where the students can definitely get the help they need from the teachers.
So what is the advantage of being small on the market?
Well, the advantage is that the student will get this one-on-one support that they probably won't get in a larger environment. If we keep it around 30 students per class, it works two ways. The students feel more comfortable, they're more confident to participate, to speak up, to ask questions. And also, the lecturer has a smaller group to look at, so the lecturer can give more attention to every student.
Exactly. And, right, so probably the student's also known by their name.
Absolutely. I mean, here we practically know every student on campus by their name.
Ребята, профессора, учителя, преподаватели знают каждого студента по имени. Представляете?
Yeah, that's amazing. That's great.
Absolutely. Okay. And this is just an other example of the Intercontinental Sanctuary Cove. So we also, that's also owned by us, and we also have students there doing their internship, plus
so
students working.
Tell me about the internships.
Mm-hmm.
How can they get an internship?
Well, the internship for the, let's start with a bachelor course, the Bachelor
yeah.
of Business in Hotel Management. So there's a compulsory 6-month internship.
Compulsory. So students, they must do it.
They must do it. It's
yeah.
part of their course.
Yeah.
This happens in the second year, right?
Yeah.
Because it's a 3-year degree. It happens in the second year. And, well, we prepare them before they go for the internship. So in
yeah.
the first year, they will actually do a internship preparation subject. So they have to pass this subject,
yeah.
and then they're cleared to do the internship in the second year. So the internship for the Bachelor of Business goes for 6 months.
Six
right?
months.
It's a 6-month internship.
Is it paid internship?
It varies, you know, it depends on where. Some of them will not be paid, they just want to give you the experience, but some of them will indeed be
mm.
paid internship. Really depends on the students where they want to go, right?
Yeah.
If you're looking for a paid internship, definitely some of them are.
Yeah.
And the good thing about them is either they're paid or not. A lot of times, you know, if the student does a good job, the student is performing well in that internship, a lot of times these actually translate into work opportunities as well, because the employer, they see that you're doing what you need to do, they like the way you work.
Yeah.
It's in their advantage at the end of it to say, hey, you know, well, you're finished your 6 months now, but we would like to actually have you on board.
Ребята, кто учится на бакалавриате, второй год обучения предлагается стажировка. Стажировки бывают или оплачиваемые, или неоплачиваемые. Чаще всего все-таки бывают оплачиваемые стажировки. Даже если это неоплачиваемая стажировка, очень большой шанс и вероятность, что вам будет предложена работа после окончания вашей стажировки. Иными словами, у вас будет работа 20 часов в неделю уже до окончания курса. Вот так вот, ребята, вы можете отучиться и работать во множестве отелей, которые предлагает вам отельная школа. Поэтому, если вам понравилось это видео, поставьте классы и лайки, а также подписывайтесь на этот канал. Здесь будет очень много интересного из Австралии, об Австралии, об иммиграции в Австралии, об получении образования в Австралии, об изучении английского языка по всему миру. Наш сайт www.immigration.com. Добавляйтесь в друзья в Фейсбуке и ВКонтакте, подписывайтесь на канал, и я увижу вас в следующих видео. Пока! And say bye to all Russian-speaking students.
Goodbye, folks. It was nice to talk to you.
See you next time, guys.